In the U.S., ousted lawmaker Justin Pearson condemns what he called political lynching being led by the Republican Party. Last week, the Republican-led Tennessee House of Representatives expelled two black lawmakers, Pearson and Justin Jones, after leading a protest calling for gun control. The demonstration was mounted in the wake of the March 27 school shooting in Nashville, which killed three children and three adults.
The Republican-led supermajority of the Tennessee General Assembly sought to have a political lynching of three of its members because we spoke out of turn against the status quo of the government after the tragic deaths of six people in the shooting at the Covenant School in Nashville. They convinced themselves that this would be the end because we wouldn't see past the veil of their faux democracy and understand it for what it truly is, which is a mobocracy ruled by the rules of white supremacy and patriarchy.
For an analyst, the expulsion of Pearson and Jones from the Tennessee State House sets a dangerous political precedent.
This is an indication of a really deeply anti-democratic sensibility, the idea that, you know, that people would take advantage of having the power of the supermajority to disenfranchise potentially millions of voters, in this case, thousands of voters who deserve to have representation. The refusal to actually respond to what the vast majority of constituents want, which is common sense, gun reform, protection of communities and well-being, and particularly of children, and, you know, a society that is fair, that is just, that is open, that we have elected representatives, and it appears an entire party that simply does not believe in those principles and will abrogate the rights of anyone who, refuses their ideology.
Over in Ukraine, President Volodymyr Zelensky used his evening message on Easter Sunday to slam Russia's latest attack. Russia's strike in southern Ukraine, which was carried out during the Orthodox Church's observance of Palm Sunday, killed a 50-year-old man and his 11-year-old daughter. It was the latest in a series of recent attacks on civilian targets as Moscow's full-scale invasion drags into its second year.
Every bright Christian holiday teaches us that we may not know how, but we must be sure that evil will lose. We have to believe, and we do. We have to bring the defeat of evil closer, and we are bringing it closer.
Bad news for motorists, as a big-time oil price hike is set to take effect this week. Gasoline prices will rise by 2 pesos and 60 centavos per liter, while diesel prices will increase by 1 peso and 70 centavos per liter. Kerosene prices, meanwhile, will go up by nearly 2 pesos per liter. Prices rose due to the Organization of the Petroleum Exporting Countries' decision to cut oil production. Philippine government agencies joined forces to create a contingency plan to stave off a possible water crisis brought on by El Nino. Climate projections by PAGASA earlier showed El Nino will begin by the third quarter of 2023 and will last until next year. The National Water Resources Board asserts the country is more prepared now than before to respond to a possible water crisis. The NWRB is currently coordinating with the Metropolitan Water Works and Sewerage System and the National Irrigation Administration to address the concern.